So it is Japan against New Zealand, and six ends instead of four. And the other, that's of course BC1 and BC2 categories, we should mention that. And at the other end of the court are other representatives of the team, the coaches or substitutes. What's going on?
Yeah, exactly. Mm. Normally there'll be a coach down the far end, and also substitutes. So they can only substitute in between ends.
Mm-hmm. Lin Ten, I think, is our referee, is it?
That's Shen, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She's from Taiwan.
Taiwan, okay. And the 2-minute warm-up period has elapsed, and now we're just getting ready for everyone to be given the go-ahead. And so New Zealand's got the red ball, so they'll be first away.
Yeah, it always starts off from the box furthest away from us.
Mm-hmm. So on that far side, that's Gary Williams.
Yep. He's a foot player, so he'll be throwing the jack, and then he has to play the next ball.
Mm-hmm.
After that, anyone can play. Mm-hmm. Well, obviously.
Everything just about ready now.
Just waiting for the other courts.
Mm-hmm. Had some rather cheeky initiations of the session. You know, let's get ready to rumble. Was that you?
That's not me. It's the head ref.
Okay.
Poor coffee from New Zealand, so.
206 is Hiroshi Takayuki from Japan. And 220 there is Jeremy Morris from New Zealand. Athletes just using these moments to perhaps visualise and gather themselves, try and settle the nerves. I don't know whether, you know, perhaps first time in front of the cameras might be something for them to worry about.
Yeah.
Hopefully not.
Well, probably just at the start of the game. Once it gets going, they'll forget about that.
Mm. So Japan picking from a squad of five.
New Zealand had originally had four players here, but one of them's been classified out, so we've lost our spare, which is unfortunate.
And how often do the athletes get through the classification process?
Normally, once every tournament they'll be looked at, and because we've got a number of new ones, they all pretty much all got looked at. So.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like the other courts where they have ramp assistance can take quite a bit of organising. So.
Yeah, they're not quite ready yet. We're all set to go here. Jeremy, closest to us on this near side.
Gary Williams is from Christchurch.
Mm-hmm. And yourself from Auckland?
Yeah, yeah. Actually, Jeremy is also from Christchurch.
Mm-hmm. It's always a challenge and an expense getting your athletes together too.
Yeah.
How many times a year might they be able to do that in New Zealand, your representative players?
We sort of have it at the Nationals, and we'll also, obviously these sorts of tournaments, but we'll also have a camp at some stage. We normally only have one. Don't quite have the funds yet.
All right, we must be close to getting a start.
Just a couple of courts getting themselves organised.
Mm-hmm. You've been satisfied with the efficiency of the tournament, the way it's been run?
Yeah, no, it's been very good actually. Also, you know, all the reffing, there's been no protests, no dramas, it's all gone very well.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah,
to hear.
Yeah.
As the referees have been drawn from right around the region too, and including Gary, of course, from Canada.
Yeah.
Great experience for them.
Yeah, normally they advertise. We're off. Hey.
So the three from Japan, Hiroshi Takayuki, Katani. Sorry, Takayuki Hiroshi, Takayuki Kitani, and Hidetaka Sugimura. I hope I've got that out all right. But anyway, it's Gary Williams to get us away.
Yeah, I'll be looking to get a good one on the jack this time.
Just a little short.
Yeah, he won't be overly happy.
So the blue team is actually the team dressed in red, so try not to get too confused by that. Japan with the blue balls. And up comes Sugimura.
Is he going to throw? Yeah, it can be quite confusing as to who's actually going to throw. Anyone can throw.
Yeah, it's
here we go, it's the middle man.
Yeah. So instead it's Hiroshi.
Lovely shot.
Well done. And he likes it.
Yeah. So you can use the angles more by getting players that are, that have a good angle onto the...
Little discussion there between New Zealand players. Who's going to go next?
Gary Williams is our captain. So,
Gary Williams, who sent the jack, he's really got no angle to work with because he's got a short one on his own line there.
Actually, it's a beautifully positioned jack because it's difficult for the whole three in New Zealand to do anything about it.
Mm.
I think they might have to break it up or do something, I'm not sure.
And they could be forced into a defensive mode quite early.
Because you've got six ends, you can have a bit of tolerance, but you shouldn't lose an end by too much. Otherwise, you're behind the eight ball.
From a referee's perspective, Harvey, what are some of the... Oh, we've hardly seen any, but what are some of the transgressions that can occur on the court? An obvious one is a chair with the wheels over the line, but what else might draw a penalty?
Oh, the rule book is 54 pages long, so...
Well, you don't have to go through all of them, but perhaps the more common ones that, that are easier to explain.
Yeah, let's think. God, my mind's gone somewhat blank here. But if two people throw balls at the same time, often one will be they'll be retracted. If time is running out and there's the referee thinks that the they're throwing balls in order to save time, that'll be an infringement. Inappropriate communication between various parties. Like at the moment, the coaches down here aren't allowed to be talking to the players. They can only give encouragement. And B, most of the penalties occur in the ramping games where there's more issues to happen.
Yeah, so the ramp assistants, you've got to keep a close eye on them and make sure that they do what they're supposed to do and not turn around and look at inappropriate times. And that's difficult.
You've been reading the rules.
Well, who's watching them? Seeing what they're watching. How many things you've got to watch at once?
Yeah. The thing at this level is they're normally very good. And they no one wants to give a penalty away, you know.
Japan still holding with that solitary blue ball at the moment, still obliging New Zealand to play.
Oh, that's not bad. It's quite a good defensive shot because it'll block some of the ability of Japan, but at the moment the door's pretty wide open, and New Zealand has to close it, otherwise they're going to be in trouble.
Matthew Whiting in the middle for New Zealand. and Jeremy Morris on this near side.
I think it's down to Jeremy now. He's probably the best player in the team. He'll be feeling the pressure now.
Mm. Still got a minute 30 on their clock, New Zealand.
Okay.
That's good
That's a good effort. That could save, you know, losing by one or two. Plenty of ends to come back.
Yeah, they needed that one in close.
Mm. The door's been nudged a little close. Close.
Sugimura is the captain, 209. Hidetaka Sugimura. Pretty pleased to step up holding shot with the now New Zealand team out of ammunition. Hiroshi, is she coming up to have a look? Sugimura. In the case there where the captain's coming up and having a look, Captain Harvey, what would happen if he accidentally rolled a wheel across the ball and moved it?
A referee's nightmare. Normally what will happen is they'll try and replace them to as best they can. And normally you'll get the agreement of all the players. If you get all the agreement, you go ahead.
Mm.
If there's sort of a big loss of confidence or if it's a bad knock, which has really disturbed a lot, then you have to replay the end.
Right.
Yeah.
And there's not a penalty against the
no,
player?
No.
Okay.
Severe scolding.
Mm.
That's about it.
Yeah, and the scowls of the other team. So. Well, that last ball probably only helped New Zealand. They've now got a couple in quite close to the jack. But they're still holding.
It's going to be quite hard for Japan to... Oh, no, maybe the person who's got the best angle, although it's going to be hard to get much more here.
Well, Captain Sugimura has probably got the most traffic between him and the jack. It can be hard for him to score as he's going to play now.
And he might try and break the push the air blue away and sort of get into that nice area there where there's a bit of space and then build on it. Yeah, and a good job. Look at that, beautiful.
Yeah, oh, he's got a couple there. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
I guess one of the challenges in a teams competition, Harvey, is that, you know, the different hardness of the balls. Who do you give what to?
Oh no. Normally, all the players got their own ball, so they're not taking them from one set.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. So you can choose from your six.
Yeah.
But you can only play two.
That's correct.
Okay.
So, mind you, amongst the team, they will kind of discuss who should have some hard balls because you need them to sort of break things up. And
I'm glad we cleared that one up. That's very important and very interesting. So you can take your whole set of six out and use the two that you want as the situation arises.
Oh, sorry. No, you can't take six out onto court.
Okay.
You can from all the balls you have, you can select. Each player has their own balls.
Yeah.
And he can select two that he's going to use.
Okay.
But it's not taking it from just one set that they have to use.
Oh, no. But once you've chosen your two for the
that's
match,
it. That's it.
Yeah.
That's
so in that sense, you are restricted.
Oh, yes, absolutely. But the team will normally take out a good selection, cover the field, but Japan's doing pretty well here.
And the captain will be well aware of who's got which ball.
Yeah. Mm. And also the strengths of the players, those that can drive, those that can't.
Mm-hmm.
Also on the court, there must be a BC1 player. Mm-hmm. That's the 108 who's playing now.
Yeah, Gary Williams it is for New Zealand, and for Japan. It's Takayuki Kitani, the BC1.
And at all times, the BC1 must be on court. So if they substitute off a BC1 and there's only one, then a BC1 has to go back on. Mm.
Sugimura now. They're holding at least two.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great deflection, yeah, isn't it? That's really working off the ball to great effect. Is everyone out now?
Looks like a moderately sizable score coming up here for Japan.
It didn't look good about midway through the end. They started impressively. Then New Zealand sort of came back, but a couple of great shots towards the end.
It was a critical shot by the captain from Japan, wasn't it, that moved that jack on?
Mm.
Exactly what he should have done.
Yeah, well, I guess that's why he's got the captain's armband and the responsibility.
Yeah, yeah.
Happy to take that one away, yes. Measure the closest of the New Zealand balls and then see how many, if any, are still to be taken out for. Well, that one's in the count. So that looks like three. Three for blue it is. Well, it's a great start for Japan.
It's an excellent start.
But I guess, Harvey, not a surprise that Japan come in as warm favourites.
Yeah. And also, there's six ends, you know.
Yep.
We don't have to give up yet.
Oh, no. I wasn't suggesting that.
The Americans won the America's Cup when we were nine.
I wasn't going to bring that up. We didn't know what to make of that. But I tell you what, I was absolutely transfixed by the speed of those multi-holes. I don't want to see mono-hole America's Cup ever again. I mean, they're going around at 35 knots.
Yeah, no, it was
unbelievable.
It was dramatic.
Yeah.
And what about when that New Zealand, when the New Zealand boat almost went over?
Yeah, cartwheeling, just about. That's a lot of money down the drain, isn't it? Not that they'd sink, but they'd certainly be damaged. But, very
the whole campaign would have just finished there.
Mm. I did feel for you, though. It would have been a tremendous boost for Auckland once again to be at the centre of that action. But here we go. Sugimura throws the jack.
Mm.
Does that surprise you?
No, the shot here, no. It's a sort of two-third court. Our guys, probably Gary, is not so good on the long shot, so they're probably playing to our weaknesses. Man, everybody studies everybody in this game.
Yeah, I guess that's what it's about, scouting the opposition.
Yeah.
Sugimura to follow up the throw of the jack with Japan's first. Oh,
that's an interesting shot.
Well, I only think that's a miss unless he...
I don't think he wanted to do that.
No. He's the only one who can promote the jack down that line is him. And so I don't think that was intended.
Yeah.
Matthew in the middle. So it's a wide open jack. He disappointed if he didn't get closer than Sugimura's.
Thing is, if you're a bit short, at least you can block other people, you know. So a long shot is kind of not as good as you'd like. You really want to get one close here. If you leave a gap like that, then the other team, like Japan, will want to be next, even though they're not the furthest to get in there and put the pressure on straight away.
Yeah. With Matt Whiting's disability, though, can he throw a long ball, or is that about his range?
You can probably get further than that. In fact, this classification, that maybe they were saying that he might actually be a BC1, so they're kind of looking at him during the tournament. But it's interesting the tactics that they've used, and that we're starting with our BC1 and they're finishing with their BC1, who are normally C, but now the captain's come back to, to claim, to put the pressure on, and a great shot.
Well, if you've only got two to play, then you use one for a sighter, then your next one better be good, and it is from Sugimura.
Although the jack's still open. Still open.
So what are the Kiwis thinking here?
You'll probably get Jeremy to have a crack, I'd say. 220. They get an extra minute in teams just for the talking, just for the discussion of this. Gary's going to go. Oh, yeah, fair enough.
So Japan have one right on the jack. Got caught on the short traffic. That's not a lot of help.
Looked like it had nice weight on it too, actually.
So New Zealand obliged to play again. Jeremy got a reasonable angle to work with here, Harvey?
Yeah, I think he's got a gap. If he goes straight onto the jack, it should be a clear path, but the theory's pretty easy.
Practice something else. No, we only ever play good shots from up here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Jeremy Morris. Alright, that's one in a little closer and might yet be handy back there.
Still a wide door there, isn't there? Often that's the best way too. If you play one shot, go and have another shot. You're kind of still warm.
Yep, you've got a feel for the pace that you need. And so Morris not rushing it. Time not a problem at the moment. 2:30 left. Just needed to miss that one, didn't he?
Yeah. The door is closing, but it's big door still.
Three for Japan in the first end. A lot more attention in our first couple of days, Harvey, have been given to the singles. But in terms of practice and training for these big events, they get together as teams often enough to play together?
I don't think anyone does. I know the Koreans go into camp. They get a lot of time together. I think a lot of the other countries are always struggling. I was just talking to someone from Hong Kong and saying, hey, you're a nice little small country. I get you guys get together. He says, well, it's tough there too, you know. Normally one taxi has to go around and pick everybody up. And
right.
It takes hours. So, yeah. But for us getting the team together, it needs accommodation, flights. There's two more balls to go out. Jeremy's got rid of his. One for Matt, one for Gary by the look of it.
So Matt Whiting, throw.
Matt's got a bit of traffic to go through there. Yeah. A difficult line. Oh well, it's up to the captain now. Save the team. Bit of glory. No pressure.
Just opportunity, as we say. No pressure, just an opportunity. All right. Gary Williams.
Oh, this doesn't look too bad.
Oh, hey. Good effort. Oh, hey. Good effort. Unlucky.
Yeah. Hey.
He had a very good line there.
Yeah.
Sugimura.
Checking out how to maximise the score here. Although there's good, it's quite a good wall in front of Japan at the moment.
Here's another look at the last one from Mark Williams. She was so close to being good.
Yeah.
Better contact on that blue ball and they'd be holding.
Yeah.
In this team format, Harvey, can players other than the captain go up and have a look?
Oh, yeah.
Hiroshi can't get through. They're well blocked.
He's just added to the wall.
Makes it even harder.
Yeah. And the only person who's got a line, the captain, has used his ball, so.
Hiroshi just re-maneuvering, trying to create just the right angle.
Stay within the box.
Yes, he's just checking to make close. Sure the wheels are all right. Hiroshi. And again blocked. I can't see a change to the score happening, really. There are so many short balls on this end. Sugiyama is going to go and have another look. Could be Japan only score one here after three in the opening end.
Look, I think New Zealand's got a chance here.
Mm.
If they knock that wall a bit closer to the jack, we'll be in.
I like your optimism, Harvey.
It's not over till it's over.
Yeah.
But, he's going to have a go.
We saw where Australia was silly enough to put their hand up to be a challenger for the America's Cup next time, so we're back in it.
Guys are the what do they call that, the
Wild Oats people. It's the syndicate.
You're the challenger of record.
Challenger of record.
Yes. You guys got in very quick, didn't you? Jeez. We were still crying by the time you gave it. Right, here we go.
Catani. Trying to barge his way through. Nearly.
It's always a risk, isn't it? Always a risk. Sometimes in this game. Greed or safety.
So one to blue. As the outcome. Those short red balls just couldn't be penetrated. And they've won the first two ends, but only by one in the second. Japan a 4-0 lead after two against New Zealand in this opening teams event. So what will be the tactics? We've seen a long end thrown by Japan. They didn't really cash in.
No, they didn't. In fact, I think that first ball, the first ball, if you don't get your first ball going nicely, then it kind of, and that wasn't a good first ball. But,
no. Surprising from Sugiyama, yeah.
And they've got their power at the beginning, like, their captain's playing first for Japan, so. I think if New Zealand can kind of just make sure they don't get too far away, but they're starting to make a bit of a move already, aren't they?
Matt Whiting has the jack.
probably a good spot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so New Zealand, the way they line up in the boxes, they're slightly closer to that far side. So that all makes sense.
That's looking pretty reasonable. Ah, no, bit of an opportunity for Japan to come back in there quite quickly.
So Whiting would love that to have stopped just in front of the jack, but it's not too far away.
Yeah. He wouldn't have been overly disappointed with that shot. That's not too bad, but the captain might have... Yeah, the captain will take responsibility for Japan to try and put the pressure back on New Zealand.
So it'll be Hidetaka Sugimura.
Ooh. Mm. Hey.
He's not quite on top of his game, is he, Sugimura?
No,
he's had a loose one
.
At the start of the previous end.
Good ball. Using up their big cannons early.
Well, he did make a great correction with his second ball.
He did, didn't he?
In the previous end. Let's see if he can do that again.
Hmm.
No. Well, he's not got the feel for it this afternoon.
No. Quite a few sighs coming from Japan at the moment.
Yeah, so the door's a little open here for the Kiwis. Let's see if they can barge through it. But they don't get the opportunity yet because they're still holding, so that's fine for them. Hiroshi to play. Close, but is it closer?
I don't think so.
Still blue.
I'm getting a little worried now. This is about when you start getting worried.
Still blue to play is what I mean.
He doesn't look worried though, does he?
No.
Really? No, he looks pretty calm.
I think that's an elite sport. That's part of the game, isn't it? To show nothing with your body language that you're concerned about how things are proceeding.
He wasn't worried because he wasn't throwing. It was the other gentleman.
Yeah, Kitani, and he's missed the target area.
But he's doing the right thing, trying to promote the blue onto the check. So he just has to get his line right.
Mm. Would have had a good outcome, just a couple of centimetres to the left of there. Kitani again, and misses the other side.
Oh.
Are you still worried?
Yeah, here he goes. I know. It's a replay. Yeah. Went both sides, eh?
Mm. Right, so Japan obliged to play on. Still New Zealand holding. At this time it might be those bocce balls of Japan that stopped New Zealand getting to the target. Well, we'll see. That's I'm projecting a little too far into the future there.
Great shot.
Ah, that's
great
better.
Shot.
Yeah,
great
well
shot.
Done, Hiroshi. Yeah. Takayuki Hiroshi's come up with a wonderful ball.
Yeah. Great pressure.
Promotes his own onto the jack, and that's going to be very hard to shift.
It's quite a hard ball,
So
of course you got to hit it, but probably be able to move it. And I think, as a Gary, I think he's got a bit of a channel through there.
So Harvey, even from a distance, you can tell which are the hard ones and the soft ones?
Just the way they roll.
Yeah.
Gary's ones are not overly hard, so he's Probably just got to draw it in there. I don't think he's got the power to kind of knock things around about too much.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a matter of sneaking one in there. Oh,
he's had a good drive at it.
I take everything back that I said.
That was a good attempt. And that, now the jack is a little more available. He's really upset the head there. But it's...
Man, he powered that one in a while.
Yeah, there's Japan's blue ball sitting either side of the jack. Now, can he send one up the middle? It's available.
Yeah.
If he's accurate enough. Different pace about this one, imagine. Oh, just slightly offline.
Man, that's a pretty crowded jack now, isn't it?
Mm.
Yeah.
But that last one from Gary, it may be able to be promoted if either Jeremy or Matthew got the angle on it.
Yeah, it looks pretty crowded from Jeremy's point of view, I think. So those balls aren't really soft, so I could still easy to upset that whole area.
Down 4-0 after 2, New Zealand, but got an opportunity here. Jeremy Morris. It's not quite the target area, was it?
Actually, it wasn't bad, but it just didn't have the power to kind of really push stuff away.
Mm. So he wasn't trying to promote the earlier ball of Gary Williams. Closest.
I think it looks pretty crowded with blues at the moment.
Mm.
The idea of trying to push that jack across to the other red is probably the only way of getting a point here. Yeah, they're all blue around that jack, aren't they?
Mm. Well, just that red one on the short side.
Yeah, yeah.
It's almost locked out at the moment, though.
Mm.
Matthew Whiting. 90 seconds left for New Zealand.
All of the Japanese balls are gone, so it's just New Zealand throwing.
Nope.
Ah.
That's,
there you go.
That's not helpful.
All right, it comes down to Jeremy Morris.
So I ask him to have a look, I think. And they've got a minute, so Gary's got to be efficient with the time. So I think heavy contact on one of the darker blue ball would push the jack through to the red. So there are possibilities here.
Going to take a bit of luck.
Yep. Arrive with weight and see what happens. Give yourself chances.
It's a Hail Mary shot.
Mm. Jeremy Morris.
Ooh.
Oh, good try. Now, where is that finished? How close
done,
is it?
Jeremy.
He wants to be contacting the jack.
Going for a measure.
This could be a torch job. We'll just see how close they are. Now, is that red ball
that
touching?
Looks like, yeah, doesn't it? That's looks like one there,
couple,
doesn't it?
Couple to blue, perhaps, if that red one isn't touching. two. Yeah, it is two. A further two for Japan, and they're got a healthy position now.
Yeah, halfway.
So 6-0 after three ends. Japan against New Zealand. Teams competition here at the Sports Centre, Sydney Olympic Park. We were talking America's Cup a minute ago. Someone once described competitive big boat sailing to me as like standing in the shower with a raincoat on, tearing up $100 bills.
I've done that.
Well, it's an expensive sport.
Yeah,
and
it shows,
and all you do is get wet.
Yeah.
It can be fun, though.
Did you watch many of the races?
Oh, we did. I was coming into Australia, and I in my younger days, I was keen on sailing, and I was just fascinated. I used to sail a Hobie Cat, and I thought they were quick. But to see these yachts flying around at 35, 40 knots.
Yeah, quite amazing, isn't it?
80 kilometres an hour or so. My goodness, how do the chase boats even keep up with them? And they're just about out of control, aren't they? They're right on the edge.
A great spectacle, actually.
Yeah, New Zealand, the great tradition in America's Cup sailing, and I guess looking to rebuild one here in Bocce. And
actually, it's good to see Australia back in the America's Cup as well.
Mm, yeah.
I was lucky enough to be in Perth when Alan Bond won.
All right.
Got off America for the first time
ever. Yeah, 83.
That was a special day.
Mm. I just had the anniversary for that, 30-year anniversary.
Mm. Oh, really?
Mm.
Sheesh.
Yes, John Bertrand and a few of the boys were called in to celebrate the occasion.
So a timeout's been called here. I'm not sure who has called the timeout. By the screen, it looks like it's Japan that's called the timeout. So you're allowed one timeout per team.
Mm-hmm. Well, they haven't played perhaps as well as they could, but they're still sitting on a 6-0 lead. So I wonder what they need to talk about when they've won the first three ends. But
that's a very good point.
Mm.
They might be talking about strategy of bringing people on, taking people off.
Mm. It's not particularly broken. What have they got to fix?
Now it's handy they call a timeout for New Zealand.
the Kiwis can make the most of it too.
We only have one coach, and he'll be with the BC3 team, I presume. Yes, he is.
Okay.
So captain here has got a bit of botcher under his belt anyway, so he'll have enough words of wisdom to pass on. I think the main one will be get closer to the jack, boys. Get closer to the jack.
One of the challenges of drawing people into Paralympic sport in Australia is making potential athletes aware of a sport that might suit them. Is that true in New Zealand as well? You've got plenty of potential people with disability that could be involved, but they haven't been made aware of it, or they're reluctant. Or
well, one of my other jobs is I work for the Cerebral Palsy Society in New Zealand. We have a membership of about 1,000, and it's quite difficult actually. It's easy to get the sport known, like these sort of broadcasts, etc. But it's quite tricky to actually then get to that next stage of making a commitment to come along or do something or check it out. And we still struggle a little bit to get more people into the game.
Mm.
So it's always tough. But the great thing about botcher is anyone can play it, really.
Yeah.
And the degree of disability is probably the most, for the ones in BC3s, very disabled.
Mm.
But they can get out on their court, and boy, they can play well. Mm. And the adrenaline's pumping, everything's pumping.
Yeah,
it's brilliant. Hello, they're just having a bit of trouble with the scoreboard here, but they'll get it sorted out shortly, and then we'll start the game.
Yeah, halfway through, perhaps the halfway point's a good time to have a timeout. As good as any. When we can't think of the reason why they needed one.
They've still got the same three players they started with, so they'll just keep adding to their success so far.
Mm.
So the jack, the person who throws the jack, slowly makes its way across the court,
right,
till the last person. If someone fouls the jack, it just goes to the next person. in the queue, and if the last guy fouls the jack, then it goes back to the first player.
So. Okay, makes its way around. So, Tucker,
so now they're just getting the number of ends sorted.
So we're up to the fourth end. Scoreboard looks as though it's got everything in order. 6-0 is the score.
So if you're a New Zealander, you hope they get that wrong and we'll give us the points.
Just put in 6 under New Zealand there and we'll make it a drawn game. Not yet.
Not yet. Oh, they can't quite get the end sorted out.
Well, we've got game over at the moment. That's not right either. Misbehaving technology.
The head referee's there, earning his money. Oh, now the officials will be feeling the pressure a little bit now.
Yeah, we've had very few technical problems. That scoreboard is not behaving. That's all right. I guess one of the other things that it's not immediately thought about by the rest of the community, though, is that for someone to take up a sport such as bocce, it involves more than one person to get the athlete there and back, and all those kinds of things take more effort and more time than most people are aware of.
Well, it's the whole family that gets involved. An athlete has to have a support system around them to get them there, help bring them to tournaments like this. So it's not just one person deciding I'd like to play bocce. It's a complete network around them that organised to do that. Oh, look at this. They're putting the pressure on the officials by putting the camera on them. There might be actually something wrong with the... one more to the fourth. It is the fourth end, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, we've got the right score on the board.
And I think we're set to go, actually.
Don't touch anything. That all looks good to us. Okay, I think we are set. So Takayuki Orosi has had a fair wait for the opportunity to throw the jack. An hour away.
It's a general strategy.
Yeah, throw long.
Yeah, it's quite a good long one too.
That'll be a test for the Kiwis, but perhaps also for Japan. Hiroshi. Well, it's got a good feel for the weight. He just threw the jack. Same again, please. That is next to perfect.
Whoa.
You give him 9.5 out of 10 for that.
It's interesting with the jack, because they only have one jack, so it might not have been his jack, you see. So they have to get the feel of it quite quickly, and then they play their ball, which will have a different feel. But that's a fantastic shot. Yeah, that's what every guy wants.
Another question without notice for you, Harvey. Is the jack the same weight as the match balls?
Yeah, well, all the balls are within a certain tolerance, and it's quite a significant tolerance, actually. So balls can be quite hard, and also the diameter of the balls is a certain tolerance. So as long as they fit the two criteria of weight and diameter, then they're allowed to be used. But if you look at some of the balls from Thailand, they fit those criteria, but gee, they're soft, flat,
squishy. Yeah, that's been a bit of a talking point around some of the other teams. And I know a few of the Australians felt after matches against Thailand, said, well, you know, I've got the shots that they've got, but I can't compete with those. I've got to get some of those bocce balls that they're using. They virtually skid across the surface, don't they?
Yeah. And once I've got to where they're going, I'm not going much further.
Matt Whiting just can't quite get it there.
Yeah.
Well, Tough distance for Matt.
Definitely playing to a bit of weakness there. So yeah.
Might be of nuisance value for Japan though. Jeremy is going to take the next shot, looks like.
Man, it's so important to get that first ball in, like Japan did.
Mm.
From then on, the rest of the other team will struggle. Right, what's the line like?
Oh,
not bad.
Very good to get a piece of the jack from that distance.
Yeah.
That's a tremendous shot from Jeremy Morris. Yeah. Good ball. He's done tremendously well here. Just see it come up and it was less than half the jack exposed.
There's a little bit of space now between the two balls, but that line is such that it's going to be hard to take advantage of it.
Mm. So from the opposite corner of the court, really, so Gary Williams.
Not a bad weight.
Mm.
Got to get one in moderately close here to make sure that Japan don't cash in.
Again, pretty good weight from Gary, but the line's not quite there. Only got one left, New Zealand.
Jeremy will be feeling the pressure here.
Whoa, good try.
Yeah, it was a good shot. Jeremy was in our team that won the team's event in Rio back in 2006. So
right, he's been around the game a while.
Yeah. That's a pretty big door, unfortunately, so it could be a good score here for Japan.
Who's it going to be? I think Hiroshi, who threw the jack and the great first ball, he's going to follow up. It was a few minutes ago, though. How's his muscle memory?
There's two.
Oh, not too bad. That's two out of two, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty good. That's an excellent shot.
Good execution. Sugimura now.
Coming in thick and fast now.
Yeah. Great line. Great weight. Great result.
Yep.
Might as well let him go again, and they do. So Sugimura. Can he repeat? Oh, yeah, got a friendly stopper there.
Yeah.
That had too much weight on it, but it got a bit of help from his teammate. This one was heading towards the sideline until, hello, I'll stop you. And that's probably four.
Yeah, no, that's four.
Takayuki Kitani, last to play.
Well,
oh, you're not quite as lucky. Yeah.
That's a great shot, though, from a BC. Excellent shot. He's got a nice wall to throw against, too, now, Blues.
Ah, that one will count. I think that one's in there. So that could be five.
I'm not sure which is the closest red. Whether it's the one more in the centre of the court or the middle of the court. I know that all looks definitive.
Come up and have a look. Well, this has been a great end for Japan. The timeout, I don't know what they discussed, but it's going to be a healthy return for them in the fourth end.
Okay, it looks like six. Oh, is that six?
Yeah. So, well, that's a big
that's
count.
That's
off, well, five. You have four fingers and one on the other hand. Just gonna wait to see what counts. once you get past five, it gets a bit difficult to see. I couldn't see that six, but anyway, we'll see what goes up on the scoreboard. Well, it was six.
Yeah, no, it's start running out of fingers.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, no, that's you can't leave a door that open at this level of competition.
So 12-0. So New Zealand need a couple of full counts to force an extra end. I can't see it.
Really? Come on.
All right.
You wouldn't get Jimmy Spittle saying that.
No, well,
you wouldn't get Jimmy Spittle saying that.
No, he's quite a skipper, isn't he?
Yeah.
Very early on in the comeback trail for that America's Cup. The American boat skippered by the Australian James Spittle. He was asked in a press conference about the situation, and say they were down 8-2 or whatever it might have been. He said, "Oh look, you know, we still believe we can win." He said, "You know, the pressure, you know, it's not on me really." And he turned to the Kiwi skipper and said, "Well, what if you guys don't win from here?" And the look on what's the New Zealand skipper's name? I can't remember his
Dean,
name.
Dean.
That's right. He said Dean's had this look in his face. Oh, he hadn't even considered that they wouldn't win from there. This sort of look of shock and horror. What if we lose from leading 8-2? And I felt at that time he'd planted the thought.
Dean Barker.
With apologies to Dean. We should have remembered that. But
I think he often won the psychological war in those after-game press conferences. Gee, and then, you know, then all of a sudden they started winning.
Yeah.
Well. Oh, well.
Another timeout here.
Yep, this will be New Zealand's timeout, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let's hope it's as effective as Japanese time out was for them.
No need to change anything from Japan's point of view?
Nah, I mean, they have the quality, unfortunately.
Mm. So, when a team's up by a significant margin, as Japan is, would you, to give some experience on the floor, put in a substitution now?
Yeah, effectively, that's what. If they've got any players they want to get some experience, and they should put them on. It's a bit like a rugby match, you know, the last 10 minutes when you're way ahead, you just put all your people on.
It's Hiroshi Kitani and Sugimura who've played the first four ends. And to see if they're going to make it. You also want to reward the team that's given you that that position. But
it looks like there's no substituting.
Yes, Sugimura is going to sit out.
Yeah.
And see, just looking for the player number there. I'm not that familiar with the Japanese team, but it's either Ushida or Jibo.
Yeah,
See if we can find that out for you.
There we go.
2-1-3, and that is Ushida, Kizo Ushida. Got other commitments shortly, Harvey. Yes. So I did want to thank you for telling us a little bit about what's going on in the sport in New Zealand, and for your thoughts about this match as well. And just want to wish you all the best for today and tomorrow, and a safe trip home. And thanks for helping us out.
No worries, Steve. It's been enjoyable.
Yeah, it's good fun, isn't it? Yeah, we like sitting here.
The job they're paying me for now. So I'll see you later.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Okay. So 12-0 is the position. Jack is with New Zealand's Jeremy Morris, and he's thrown that, and let's see. Oh, he's just scooted past the Jack. It's not the ideal start for New Zealand. Nothing much has gone their way through the first four ends. Like Kizo Ushida is going to be put straight into action. Ushida, a BC2. All right, he's coming a little closer than the Kiwis, so it'll be back to New Zealand to continue playing now until they are holding shot. So his first throw of the competition, having been brought in off the bench. Matt Whiting, looks like he's ready to play. Well, it's more his length, but he hasn't quite found it with his first. So Japan's still holding. Robert Marshall from Botch Australia back to join us, and this has been a tough outing for the Kiwis.
It has, mate. I watched a bit of it before, and yeah, they're certainly playing another class of team here, aren't they?
Mm.
And Harvey took off as quick as he could. He got sick of making excuses.
Well, we're drawn into an America's Cup discussion. That took his mind off the scoreline here. But no, it's very tough for New Zealand here.
It's tough for emerging nations, which is what New Zealand and probably Australia would class ourselves as, to come up against teams who have been competing at this level for a long, long time.
Gary Williams might have promoted that red one close enough to take shot. Shen's having a look, and could be a measure. And obviously Japan have worked out that the long jack is difficult for New Zealand to cope with.
It's a real killer in international boccia. If all three of your players on court can't go long, they'll soon work you out. And in fact, they would have worked all that out during the singles rounds, I would suspect. If all three of your players on court can't go long, you can very quickly get found out. You can really get hurt, as they did in that previous, and I think they lost it 6-0, is that right?
Yep, 6.
Yep.
So doubled their advantage in one end, going long.
That hurts, doesn't it?
And so comfortable is their position. They've made the change now. Sugimura is off.
Nice to be able to make a replacement and still put on a world-ranked player, isn't it?
So Ushida again. Well, that only helped the opposition there. That's not a good outcome for
him. Has he got another one?
No, he's thrown two.
Okay. I was going to say if he had another one, he did open it up for himself, but that's no good to him if he's only got two balls and he's used them both. And I think from the look of that, he may have made the job more difficult for his his teammates.
Hiroshi has the captain's armband now with Sugimura off the court. Hiroshi's been playing well.
What a sensational shot.
What a great shot, and he draws the applause of his teammates and those around watching. This is a heck of a shot. Stayed with it.
Oh, he did everything he had to with that, didn't he? He absolutely nailed that.
I'm glad I talked him up and he didn't let me down there, because he has been playing well.
I tell you what, well, he certainly didn't let you down. That was a sensational shot. Gone from being one down to holding two.
So Jeremy Morris, what can he see from his box?
Not an awful lot, if that angle gives us any indication.
Well, no, it looks like there's plenty of traffic in his eye line trying to get to the jack from where Jeremy is, second from the left as you look at it. What would you do?
Geez, I don't know, because...
Well, maybe they can use Gary to open things up.
It's a tough shot for Gary, being a foot player, to hit that with enough power to make much of a difference.
Oh, he's frustrated with that. He's angry with himself.
His foot caught on the floor as he was playing his shot.
So five red played. One to come. So Jeremy Morris put under lots of pressure here.
He has got a fistful of balls in front of him.
120 left on the clock for New Zealand. One to play. Harvey was just saying how difficult it is for teams competition, for players to get to practice together. It's more of something that happens at events rather than beforehand.
Yeah, that's certainly the case for us as well here in Australia, although our team has been quite lucky that our teams have generally been made up predominantly of Queenslanders and New South Welshmen. So half the team can train in Queensland quite regularly, and the other half of the team can train in New South Wales quite regularly. So we do get a little bit of cohesive training. But if you're scattered all over the countryside, it makes it hard and expensive.
Another multiple count here on the cards for Japan. They already lead at 12-0. This is the penultimate end. Six ends in team competition.
They already hold two, and you've got to think that's not going to be the last of it.
Hiroshi. He's been in great form.
Oh, and he didn't let you down again.
He didn't. I just think, oh, that was his mistake, talking him up again. It's normally the commentator's curse, but he's done enough. Make another one count. Hard to navigate through all those red ones.
Yeah, he's done a good job to come down the side there.
He did make contact. Now, I don't know about the angle here.
For their BC1.
Katani. Takayuki Takani. Ooh.
He certainly gave it enough.
Yeah. Still three, it looks, for Japan.
Yep. Katani has one left, does he? Yes.
Yeah. No clock pressure really for Japan. They've got 2.5 minutes and Katani's still getting himself organised. Now he's okay.
Oh, no, I don't think he's got enough on, mate.
No, the blockers were very much in his line. Yeah, there wasn't much he could do about that.
Well, the referee is going to measure that last one by the look of it. No, really? No, I don't think so.
Lin Tian, referee from Taiwan.
She has the paddle poised.
That's no good news for New Zealand. It hasn't been all match.
Three more.
And three more, taking them to a 15-0 score. This is Japan at their best, and New Zealand a little bit overwhelmed at the moment.
Yeah, it's tough watching them go through this.
And they will keep playing, even though New Zealand can't possibly win, because the for and against could be important.
Absolutely. They get to the end, and if there's someone on the same number of wins, these extra few points they may pick up, or points they may lose on this end, may count for something. I didn't see both of their earlier ends. Steve, do they go long on both of their earlier ends?
No, they were a bit shorter. Well, they had one down to our right-hand corner the most recently with a jack thrown by Hiroshi, but the first end that they threw wasn't so good. Sugimura was just slightly off his game, we felt, in the first couple of ends.
That's about a 6.5 metre jack there he's thrown, so this will test the Kiwis again.
Excellent weight.
Yeah, fantastic weight from you. That's pretty good from your BC1 at 6.5 metres.
He's been a good contributor, as Takayuki Katani.
I would think they'd get Jeremy to go here, but they're not.
Well, Matthew Whiting, this is a distance he could struggle with. Yeah. Well, pretty good effort.
Not a bad effort. The danger here, though, is if Matthew can't get enough on it to get down there, he then blocks up Luke to make his job even harder. Well, that's not going to cause Luke any problems, thankfully.
That's a good effort and a good weight. Jeremy Morris might be.
Yep. Looks as though he's the one going to take a shot at it.
I mean, all that's left really for New Zealand in this last end is trying to get something on the scoreboard.
Yep. Just win an end. That'd be nice for them.
Morris. It's on its way.
That's a fair effort,
oh,
too.
Oh, that's a good one.
Great
well
shot.
Well done.
Great shot. Great shot, Jeremy. He absolutely drilled that, didn't he?
Mm. And they haven't had many opportunities, New Zealand, to hand it back to Japan and say, you shoot. Let's. They've been forced to throw all their balls fairly early in the end. Until now. Ushida. Oh, good try.
That's not bad from that distance.
Still New Zealand. And it'll be Ushida again.
Quite a bit of discussion about
who
should go here. Come on, guys, you're up 15 zip.
Yeah. They don't seem too worried about it, do they? Velosi and Ushida. I mean, fairly light-hearted discussion there. Ushida, no, it's not there. No, there's plenty of short ones on the way now.
He's going right back to the back of his box. I don't know if that's going to improve his angle too much, but he seems to think so.
Mm.
Okay.
Japan.
I wonder if his plan now is to drive up one of those blues.
Staying back there.
Unlucky.
Hit very the wrong accurate. One. Yeah, very accurate.
At that distance, it is.
Kitani will have the last for Japan. The result is known. It's just what happens in these last couple of throws.
Gee, that's good work from your BC1.
Mm. No change, though.
No. Can New Zealand put a couple on here? Luke Morris still has... Jeremy Morris still has one left. And Gary has two, so...
They're going to have the same... I can see that Gary Williams has at least got a channel to shoot through.
Yep.
But Jeremy's going first, right up to the front of the box. And the jack is also open to him.
He's just going to roll this up nicely.
Couldn't find the line, yeah. The floorboards can almost provide an aiming line for him up that line.
Absolutely. It's he'll be disappointed with that, particularly after that first shot he played.
Gary Williams now. Getting towards the end of the match. New Zealand still with 2.5 minutes on their clock. Williams, has he got enough on it?
That's not a bad effort.
Oh,
holy moly.
Oh, what
incredible.
A ball. Great ball.
Great ball. Do that again.
Yeah. Sensational effort from Gary Williams. They've been outplayed here for all but the end of the match, and he's rolled one up just the right weight. Can he replicate? New Zealand holding a couple. Can it be three?
He's given that a nice old kick too. Geez, that was a good effort.
Yeah, two good efforts, one of them counting. It looks like just two to New Zealand, and their first score of the match coming in the last end.
Well done. Go to Kiwis. That's choice, bro.
Yeah, Jeremy Morris, Matthew Whiting and Gary Williams pretty much outplayed today by Takayuki Hiroshi, Takayuki Kitani, and then firstly Sugimura and then Ushida. Japan too good. Let's have confirmation that there was another couple.
Everybody's happy.
Mm-hmm. And referee goes over to timer, scorer. That's not right. Should have been another two. 15-2 is correct.
That's right,
15-2. Yeah. I put the two in. And there's the result. Well, it's a percentage booster, if you like, for Japan as they begin their team's campaign. And 13 to the good. 15-2, Japan over New Zealand in the team's competition. Asia Oceania Boccia Championships here at Homebush.